Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of Time Out for Black History, Thought for the Day. This is for March 4th, 2021. I just wanted to take a minute. Hopefully you've been following along in the news. The recent talk of the Dr. Seuss series, and that the company itself is looking at discontinuing publication of six of its books due to excessive, stereotypes, racial connotations. And this was done through a series of discussions they had with several individuals who the company itself came out and said, this isn't what the Dr. Seuss company is about. And so we are going to kind of discontinue publication of these individual books. Now, you got the big backlash, the people who are calling it cancel culture and, what's next? They're going to take away bananas because they're yellow, And so I wanted to address that real quick. I want to address this idea of cancel culture and my take on what that really means. The one I'm going to use is about, it was about a month ago, Aunt Jemima syrup. That was the one that was kind of in the news and making headlines. It was Aunt Jemima syrup, Uncle Ben's rice. And so, I got into a pretty heavy discussion with a friend who said that, he just can't get down with all this, trying to erase history. Aunt Jemima's just a pancake syrup. What's the big deal? And so we had this pretty long debate about what Aunt Jemima really is. And the funny thing is he didn't know. So Aunt Jemima was essentially a minstrel show character. There was a song written about her, and it evolved into a minstrel show character. And it would be a white man dressed up in blackface, dressed up in drag, essentially imitating his version of black woman housemaid in slave times and Jim Crow times. And so it carries heavy connotation to it. It carries a lot of racial history. And I'm not just talking about those people who live through the experiences, but those people who are educated and understand what these things really mean. So when you think about every time you go to the store and you see it on the shelf, it triggers this understanding of what our country was built on, and in some ways what hasn't left our country. Because of everything that happened in those years, you begin to understand why getting rid of Aunt Jemima isn't that big of a deal. That getting rid of it allows us to move past these relics of a bygone era. Now, don't get me wrong. I don't think you cancel history. We still study, we still learn, we still read. But having your pancake syrup named after a minstrel show character that represents everything that was bad about America isn't really something that's necessary, in the marketing. And so the company sees it in its best interest to change it also. And also always find it interesting that the people who talk about cancel culture are usually the groups that don't see themselves as the butt of the joke or the stereotype that's being perpetuated. Very often, they're the ones usually saying, get thicker skin, but it's not their groups that are dealing with these things. So I just want you to think about that. Think of some of the other things. I remember as a kid growing up, I used to watch the Dukes of Hazzard with no real understanding as a, 8-year-old, 9-year-old, what that Confederate flag meant. And a lot of the moments of the show where I wasn't aware of any of what that really represented or what it was about. A small town Southern sheriff, in a show with no black people in it. It was interesting. All right. So just think about it, and when you think of that cancel culture thing, I want you to really think about, I had some great conversations with my students today about it. And I think after we talked about it, they better understood why getting rid of these six books isn't canceling Dr. Seuss. Dr. Seuss had a past. Those people who read about Dr. Seuss knows he had some issues around race. But it's not canceling all of Dr. Seuss. It's removing those books that would have a five-year-old little kid pick up and look at the images that don't reflect the society that we're trying to perpetuate in 2021. All right. Thank you for listening.